Hello children, so your topic for today is obsessive compulsive and related disorders. It's a truly interesting topic where you'll understand what are obsessive behaviors, what are compulsive behaviors, and what is this particular disorder all about. So when we talk about the OCD, we also call it the OCD, you know, you must have seen instances where you probably must have encountered people who wash their hands quite often. If they could be touching anything, but you know, after touching everything, they would go running to the washroom in order to wash their hands, or they tend to wash it again and again. Of course, not pertaining to the current COVID times, because that's the need of the hour and we do have to wash our hands. That doesn't make us a patient of OCD or not somebody who's actually suffering from OCD just because we are washing our hands time and again. So we need not confuse it with the current times, because that has been advised by the doctors in order to ensure that there's no virus, residing, on the layer of our skin. So just to avoid that and to be safe and to ensure absolute protection from COVID-19, we are washing our hands time and again. We are sanitizing our items. So we need not really judge this aspect and try and relate it to OCD, because this is something which we are doing it, you know, as per the instructions given and for absolute safety purposes. But when we talk about OCD, the disorder actually, so people who are battling this disorder, they have a tendency to constantly wash hands, to constantly keep checking the locks of the doors, to constantly count money, to constantly keep giving orders or instructions, and they would repeat the same thing time and again. So people tend to perform certain things. So when we talk about the OCD children, people who are suffering or battling from this disorder, they are, absolutely preoccupied with these specific ideas, or so to say, they are not able to prevent themselves from, repeatedly carrying out a particular act or series of acts, that can actually affect their ability to carry out normal activities. So, they have this tendency that they can perform the same act, time and again, over and over again, this is something which is also affecting their ability to perform the other activities in the most normal manner, because they are so preoccupied, they are so obsessed with performing this one act constantly. If we talk about obsessive behavior and if we talk about compulsive behavior, these are the two parts of OCD, of course they function most importantly, which in a way actually explains the total disorder altogether. So when we talk about the first part, the obsessive behavior is basically where you are constantly thinking, about a particular idea, or it could be event, it could be a topic. You're constantly thinking, and the thoughts which have caught you up, they are very unpleasant thoughts. They are not very good and the happy thoughts. They could be the negative ones, they could be the shameful thoughts. And when we talk about the compulsive behavior, children, this is all about, performing certain behaviors, over and over again. So, you tend to perform a certain act time and again, so I've already mentioned some of the compulsions to you, where you tend to check the knobs of the door, you tend to check the latches, you tend to check the locks. You tend to wash your hands time and again. You are too much into counting the money time and again. Too much into ordering. So all of this accounts for compulsions, So people who are so obsessed, they are constantly worried that, oh my God, what if the thieves get in? What if, they could be dacoits? What if something happens? Or, they have these fearful thoughts running, shameful thoughts or negative thoughts running. So, you know, they'll go keep checking the locks of their doors, you know, in the middle of the night, before going to bed, right in the middle, as soon as they wake up. So they have this tendency to repeatedly, you know, perform the act again and again. You know, so this is what is happening with people suffering from OCD. And when we go down to some more thoughts, you know, that people battle, or so to say, some other disorders that people are battling. So one is the hoarding disorder, and they do come under the OCD only. And in the hoarding disorder, there is this difficulty which continues to prevail in terms of, you know, parting ways or discarding, you know, your own possessions, you know, and you have this need to, you know, keep them close to you or to save them. So you don't want to discard it, you know. So people have this issue with, you know, like not to discard items or not to part ways with certain possessions, and they feel that we need to save them throughout our lives. So that is hoarding disorder. When we talk about the second one, which is the trichotillomania disorder, this is a disorder where, you know, people, they start pulling their hair, and that's how they lose their hair. They have a major loss of hair, and it's a disorder where they could be just sitting and, you know, constantly pulling their hair, and that's how they start losing their hair, and ultimately they have to go in for hair weaving or hair extensions. So, yes, we do have people battling such kind of disorders also. We also have a disorder which is called the excoriation disorder, where you tend to, you know, pull your skin, or it's called the skin picking disorder. So you kind of peel it off. So, you know, so these are some kind of disorders which people are battling, you know, and they come under the OCD. And to top it all, you know, if you just, for instance, take example of anyone, a girl who's absolutely obsessed with maybe, you know, a boy, and she wants to kind of get friends with this person, and she's constantly having this thought that, you know, why is this boy not talking to me? Why is he not giving me attention? So, you know, she gets absolutely obsessed with this person. And what can be the compulsions that she can keep messaging him throughout the day? She can continuously keep giving him calls. And if she continues to behave in such a manner, probably, you know, she can develop OCD, you know, because there are cases where the boy or the girl, they get absolutely obsessed, you know, and they tend to lose their own identities in this way. You know, so constant messages, sending around, you know, over 50 messages, 100 messages in a day, you know, giving calls back to back, you know, and absolutely an obsession. So there are cases like that also that have happened. So, you know, this is one example how you can also explain, you know, OCD. People battle this obsessive compulsive disorder. And we do have some examples of compulsions, which I just shared with you. So this was all about OCD, children, and thank you so much.